If you've been laid off or you left your company, before you do anything with your 401k, find out all the ins and outs. Call Phillis today, 623-792-5496. That's 623-792-5496.
In the mid-70s, the start of individual retirement accounts and 401ks spurred a drive in American workers to pile money away for retirement. Here we are more than 40 years later, and more of us are realizing there could be a better way to think about your money for retirement. People get caught up in how much they've saved, but what you really need to think about is how much you might need to spend in retirement. And if you've been focused on saving and not on income, there's a lot you're going to learn on today's show. Thank you for joining us today on Retire Financially Fit with Phillis. Jen Rizak here alongside Phillis Sachs-Pilvinus. She is founder and president of PSP & Associates and author of the book, Creating Calm Amidst the Storm. And Phillis, when it comes to retirement income, I think this is cool that more people are aware of it, more people want it, more companies are talking about helping people get it. BlackRock just commissioned this survey. 90% of respondents are interested in retirement income. So what we've been saying forever is finally paying off, right? Recognizing that we need to look beyond just saving.
This is exciting because I've seen people who saved a lot of money who focus on growing that money and not creating streams of income, really not being able to enjoy the retirement as much as they should.
Right.
So this is exciting, and I'd love to believe in some way my screaming it from the rooftop has helped in creating it, because the whole title of my book, Creating Calm Amidst the Storm, if you have a plan and the a very key component is an income plan, because there is no retirement without cash flow, right? Mm-hmm. You'll make it if you have a plan that provides you with income. You're going to make it to and through retirement very successfully.
Right.
You could have a lot of money in the wrong places and all of a sudden the market implodes or inflation goes high or you didn't realize you have a tax bomb in your future. And guess what? You don't have that retirement of your dreams.
Right.
So this is exciting, exciting, exciting. And I'm going to take some credit for it.
Yeah, I think you should. I mean, this is something that you've been saying for a long time. We need to be focused on income instead of just focusing on saving and just focusing on growth. I mean, those are important things. Don't get me wrong.
They are.
But it comes to a certain point. Right. You got to be thinking about income. And I want to share some other numbers from this study from BlackRock. 80% of employers who responded said they want to start adding retirement income options to their plans. So that is there instead of just saving. And almost 70% said helping employees with retirement income has become more important due to the pandemic. And I think, Phillis, the pandemic is exactly why we want the title of your book, That Calm Amidst the Storm. I think that's been a big wake-up call for a lot of people that we need to get serious about thinking about income.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm glad that they're doing it and bringing it to the top. But here's my other fear. Okay. Just like, you know, back in the 70s when pensions went away because they were too expensive for employers to have that.
Right.
The Kool-Aid that they got people drinking is save, save, save. You've got control of it yourself. Mm-hmm. And, you know, really it was to save them from having to,
the liability.
Okay. So now everybody's getting interested and that's a good start. But I'm going to tell you, it is incumbent upon you to realize that you really have to be the CEO of your money. Understand that the tools that you need to do this and get the most bang for your buck. So what I'm saying, there are ways to create income and there's ways to create income. Where are you going to get the most bang for your buck?
Mm-hmm.
What do you need to do? Where are you going to get the most bang for your buck? And I worry, just like 401ks are great, especially if you're getting a match. They're great because they're forced savings. They're easy to do that. But if in that 401k plan, your income is created there, will it be the most cost-effective way to do it? Or will there be dirty little secrets inside of there? So this is great. I can't help it, because mutual funds are inside of a plan. They're laden with fees that you can't even find.
Yeah.
So really, let's get talking about income. I don't care how much you've saved. That's great. It's important that you've saved something. We call that the heavy lifting. But now how are we going to create a stream of income that's going to last as long as you do and allow you to live independently and on your own terms, regardless of all the storms that are going to come along? Create calm amidst the storm by having a great income plan. But let's take it a step further. This is why I do this show each week. Let's make sure we understand the pros and cons and strings attached of each tool and try to do our very best to get the most bang for our buck. And I believe that there are all solutions are not created equal. Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's my only fear. I hate to rant about that. I'm excited that people are thinking about income, not just if I had a nickel for every time somebody said to me, well, I get enough money. If I just take X percentage, I'm good. And then they're sitting there with a tax bomb and they're sitting there with all kinds of risk that could implode their plan tomorrow, even though they've saved a lot. Gosh, I'd have a ton of nickels. So it's exciting. It's so exciting.
Yeah.
That you're thinking about income now because that's the key. Just like your paycheck, you know, has gotten you to this point. So look, I really want to give you an independent option. You know, just really make sure that you have a strong income plan and you're doing the right things by guiding you, educating you with all the tools and the pros and cons and strings of those. So the way to get that started is to pick up the phone right now. You ought to, okay? 623-792-5496. Let's go through my retire fit analysis. And a key component is whether you have a solid income plan in place. Not just how much money you've accumulated, although that matters. Mm-hmm. I'm not Houdini if you haven't saved anything, right? But if you have, let's go through what your income plan really consists of. I've got to break it down. Before you go picking the products and whether your 401k is going to do the right thing for you, here's why you should pick up the phone. If you can't take out a couple pieces of paper that answer these questions, you don't have an income plan. And that without cash flow and retirement, there is really no retirement. So here's why I want you to pick up the phone. And again, the number is 623-792-5496. So listen closely. First, you need to figure out how much do you need? What do you want your retirement to look like? What's it going to cost you to finance that? Or not even a cost to enjoy that, right? Mm-hmm. A simple income plan. Simple income plan rather than just the tools is when is that income going to start? And where's it going to come from? You should be able to see that loud and clear. What order am I going to take my money from? Am I going to take it from my retirement account first? Or am I going to take it from my Roth? Or am I going to take it from my after-tax account? What combination am I going to do that? Real simple. How do I get raises in retirement? Mm-hmm. Where is that going to come from? Because inflation never sleeps. You get raises while you work. Well, how do I have an income, you know, when inflation erodes what I need to maintain my lifestyle? Where's that money coming from? Mm-hmm. A really good income plan is going to show you that loud and clear. Really simple, laid out for you. Where does the money come from? If you're married and at the first death, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to blow this out of the water. You're not going to spend less because your taxes are going to go up if you lose a spouse and you're going to lose the smaller Social Security. So where is that extra income coming from? Mm-hmm. Where is it laid out in my simple income plan? And what if I need custodial care? Where is that money coming from? Do I want to decide later on, I call that crisis planning, when it happens and not have a plan for that? That's crazy. Mm-hmm. And here's the biggest question that people really have on their mind. How long is my money going to last? How long? A really good, solid income plan, not just a tool that looks pretty and it tells you you're going to get X amount of dollars of income. Really solid, good income plan is going to show you mathematically how long your money is going to last. So those are the things that your income plan should really do for you. It's great that everybody's talking about income and that your employers are going to get in the market. But if you can't pick up a piece of paper or two pieces of paper that lays this out simply, and you can't answer these questions or you're not sure you can, pick up the phone and call us because that's what we'll do for you. 623-792-5496. We'll put that plan together for you. And if you're like most, you're going to come into my office with a ton of stuff all over the place. Maybe it's in a box. Maybe it's in a portfolio. You're going to come in with a performance report that your advisor said, oh, your portfolio is doing so great. But you won't have it in a format that lays out these five questions mm-hmm. as easily as I just did. And if that's the case, don't feel bad because most people don't have it. But that's what we do all day, every day. That's what I want to do for you. No obligation attached. Pick up the phone. Call us 623-792-5496. Come in with all the stuff. Let's see if when we put into our software, if we can answer these five questions. And if there's a gap, what's the gap? Where is the problem? And now what tools can we use to fix it? 623-792-5496. I am so excited that people are talking about income. It's more important than just how much you've built up. Mm-hmm. But now let's get it even better. Let's make sure we're in control of that and do the very best with that income plan. Not just one size fits all that sounds good.
Right. And Phillis, there are so many people who are really planning for the best case scenario. They're just hoping that the worst won't happen. And those questions that you just went over helped us get, I think, a little bit more realistic when it comes
That's
to what
exactly
could
happen. That's exactly right. That's you can't, if you plan for the worst and the worst, I mean the best and the worst happens, you're stuck. Yes. So a really good, solid income plan. Thanks for saying that. Plans for the worst, but hopes for the best. We go after the income that you want and build it in a way that we fortify it no matter what storm comes along. Period.
Exactly. That number again is 623-792-5496 to reach Phillis Sachs-Pilvinus and the team at PSP and Associates. Again, 623-792-5496. It happens too often where people are planning for the best case scenario, but listen to some of those questions that Phillis just went over today. You want to be planning for the worst case scenario. You got to plan for the worst and hope for the best. And that's what the RetireFit analysis is all about. 623-792-5496. This is Retire Financially Fit with Phillis. We'll be back.
When it comes to your health, it's clear. You consult your doctor. So why not consult a professional when it comes to money? Just like your doctor, the advice you get from a financial advisor can have a direct impact on your quality of life. Are you paying too much in fees with your current financial professional? What could happen to your nest egg if there's a market correction? If you're unsure, it may be time for a second opinion. Phillis Sachs-Pilvinus is an independent advisor. She doesn't have a boss on Wall Street. Phillis and her team at PSP and Associates specialize in designing retirement strategies that can allow you to spend more time enjoying life and less time being concerned about your finances. Get your second opinion. 623-792-5496. Phillis Sachs-Pilvinus and PSP and Associates can help make sure your golden years are just that. Golden. 623-792-5496. That's 623-792-5496. Investment advisory services are offered through PSP Financial Services, LLC, an Arizona registered investment advisor. Phillis Sachs-Pilvinus is also a licensed insurance agent in the state of Arizona.
Thanks for joining us today. This is Retire Financially Fit with Phillis. I am Jen Rizak, happy to be here with Phillis Sachs-Pilvinus. She is founder and president of PSP and Associates and author of the book Creating Calm Amidst the Storm. Phillis was the first female advisor on the cover of Senior Market Advisors magazine. So glad to have her here today as we talk about the main pieces, the main pillars you need for a sturdy retirement. I'm Jen Rizak alongside, by the way, I don't know if I mentioned my own name or not, Phillis. I think I got carried away there. But retirewithpsp.com is the website if you want to learn a little bit more about Phillis and the team. You can also check out a lot of great resources available there on the website, retirewithpsp.com. And Phillis, as we think about these main pieces of retirement, what I visualize is a structure that has those four big pillars, four big columns in the front, and they're there to keep that thing up. And if you take some of them away, you're not going to have a very sturdy structure. The whole thing could come crashing down. And that's kind of the visual we want you to have with your retirement. The pillars that we are saying that you need are protection, income, liquidity, and growth. So let's talk a little bit about those pillars of protection and income, because obviously, Phillis, you've got to have income in retirement, but you also have to make sure that you protect it so it'll still be there. So these two really, really go hand in hand, don't they?
Oh, absolutely. And they all do. Each of these pieces, one of them, yeah, really, your retirement's messed up, to be be blunt. You need all of them. But let's talk about income and protection, because you're 100% right. Just like, you know, if, when you don't have a paycheck when you're working, if all of a sudden that goes away, there's a little bit of a problem. Well, in retirement, you've worked your entire life and you want income to be able to pay those bills that you still have to pay every month and to enjoy. So that's extremely important. And you have to, you do have to protect that, because you don't want to go back to work.
Right.
Okay. And there's other things that you need to protect. So when we talk about income, so we've figured out what you want to do in retirement in your personal circumstances, not the guy next door, not the couple on the other side, but your circumstances, what your life's going to look like. We come up with a good estimate of what it's going to cost you. Now we want to look to where are we going to get that income from? What are our reliable sources of income that just are not going to go away? They're going to be there till the last one stands if you're married, okay, or to you stand if you're not, such as Social Security. Now, I've said this once, I've said it probably 100 different times. Social Security, I really believe if you're over 55 years old, although they'll make tweaks to it, I don't think that they're really going to take away our Social Security. Having said that, could they mess around with the cost of living increase and things of that nature? Yes. So what we want to do is make sure, rather than just make a knee-jerk decision, take it too early or too late, make a very well-informed decision so we can optimize Social Security. Ring out every dollar and cents. But don't make it in a vacuum. There's a lot of different claiming strategies. Let's look at it together, your claiming strategy, in the context of everything else that you have. So we can consider your tax liability of taking it early, the longevity liability of taking it early or later. And I'm going to tell you, everybody's situation is so different. Three families come in a given day, I might have three entirely different recommendations. So we want to make sure we understand your fixed sources of income and make a great decision on those. We also want to make sure if you have a pension that we understand whether the pension, if they have strong claims paying ability, what the best way to take that pension is, should you take it in a lump sum? A lot goes into this, but we walk you through it in bite-sized pieces so that you can make a very well-informed decision. That's part of our Retire Fit analysis process.
And let's talk a little bit about, real quickly, Phillis, I think it's a good place to mention, how do we get started on that Retire Fit analysis? We can pick up the phone, we can give you a call, talk a little bit about how we can reach you to get started on that.
Yeah, okay, so you can actually go to our website, retirewithpsp.com, and there's a calendar link so that you can set an appointment there and someone from our office will call you to make sure you get all the right information to bring in to utilize that time. So that's retirewithpsp.com, or call us at 623-792-5496. And this is going to be value-added time, whether you're already retired, whether you're about to retire. For those of you who've worked hard, you've done some of the heavy lifting, you've saved at least $250,000 or more for retirement, and you want to make sure that you have things in the right places so that you can, you know, live your life independently on your own terms. So great. I'm glad you reminded me to give out the phone number, 623-792-5496. So when it comes to income, you want to make sure that you protect those reliable sources, make the right decisions on that, whether it be your pension, whether it be your Social Security. You also want to compare what you're going to need in income minus these reliable sources of income and what your gap is. How much of what you've saved, if you're like most people, you have a gap between what those guaranteed sources or reliable sources of income are and how much you're actually going to need each month coming in to be able to live your retirement independently and on your own terms. We need to determine what that is. We need to factor that for inflation. And then we need to see what is the best way to build out your income plan. Now remember, if you're going to need it in the short run, here's where protection comes in. Unless you have a crystal ball and you know what the stock market's going to do, okay, you need money coming in, you need to have that money coming in reliably, and you probably want to take a little bit less risk if you're going to need money in the next year to 5 years. I'll give you a perfect example. We had a client, we set up an income plan for them in December when the market was skyrocketing. Okay, and you know that this is a volatile year.
Right.
They were inclined to take more risk till I showed them what that would do to their income plan, how much they were taking. And they erred on the side of caution. And when the market went down, they're enjoying their retirement. Need I say more? So, yeah we want to make sure we have protection on that income, at least over the short years, because we don't want it to impact what we can spend. We also have to protect our income and make sure if we're married that it's there for our spouse if something happens to us prematurely. I always say this, but my husband and I agree. I go 15 minutes before him, so we're not going to have that income problem.
No way.
But that's right. But so many people could if you don't protect that income. So you've got to have inflation-adjusted income. It's got to be reliable. The sooner you're going to need it, the less risk you want to take on that income. As you go further out, you have time to recover for markets' ups and downs. When it comes to protecting that income, you also need to consider how much income are you going to receive in your hand after you pay taxes. That's where tax planning comes in. It's so important to understand, hey, I got $1 million in my retirement account. Well, how much of that are you actually going to keep? It's not the whole million. We also want to make sure that that income doesn't go away and become devastated, just dissipate if we have a healthcare crisis. So we want leverage for our healthcare crisis in there. So the income and protection go hand in hand. You know, during the accumulation phase, while we're working, our paycheck is our protected income plan. Mm-hmm. And what we save, we get accustomed to just growing it and taking all the risks that we can because it's not impacting our life right now. But too many people retire and don't realize that what they've accumulated their whole life now has to become their secure income plan. And we've got to build it more reliably, more safely. And we also have to make sure that it's going to last the rest of our lives. So we have to consider how much risk we're taking, what's appropriate in our circumstances, what our tax situation is, how much, you know, how can we be as tax efficient as possible? And how can we make sure that that income's there, whether the market's up, down, or sideways, when we're going to need it? So it all starts with, if you want to make sure that you have that right income plan, it's got to be written. And that's what we do with our retire fit analysis. Once we determine how much income you need, we'll build with you a retirement income plan that's going to be tax efficient, inflation adjusted, and something that you can't outlive. And the number to call to get started is 623-792-5496.
This is Retire Financially Fit with Phillis. That number one more time, 623 792-5496. And Phillis, I just want to point out as well, real quickly, this is a good time to get a second opinion as well, because a lot of us have done some of these things. We've thought about income, but maybe we haven't fully thought about how to protect it, or we just haven't thought a whole lot about how we'll actually get the money out of the things that we've saved. So a second opinion is a part of this as well. Could you just speak to that really quickly?
Oh, Jen, I'm so glad that you said that. So many times, and I feel bad oftentimes, people think that they have an income plan if they've saved X amount of dollars and they're taking out a percentage of that. If you don't know your risk, if you don't know what you're going to need, when you're going to need it, and you don't know the fees that you're paying, you don't know the tax liability, and you don't have this income plan, what you're going to take, when you're going to take money from which bucket, you don't have an income plan. So even if you think you do, it doesn't hurt to get a second opinion. Yes, please call us. We do it all the time. If you're in good stead, we're going to tell you that. We're always going to part friends. We'll have a few laughs, give you a little bit of information, and we'll send you on your merry old way, and that'll be great. But if there's an issue, you want to find out now versus later. And if you don't have a written income plan, there may be. 623-792-5496.
This is Retire Financially Fit with Phillis. We'll be back. Today, this is Retire Financially Fit with Phillis. I am Jen Rizak, happy to be here alongside Phillis Sachs-Pilvinus. She is founder and president of PSP and Associates and author of the book Creating Calm Amidst the Storm. RetireWithPSP.com is the website. If you'd like to learn a little bit more, they've got a lot of great information available there on the website as well. RetireWithPSP.com. And we're talking about the four pillars for your retirement plan. When you think about your retirement, visualize a structure that has four columns in front holding it up. And if you knock any of those out, the structure is going to just fall forward. And that's not what we want with our retirements. And Phillis, the two pillars that we want to talk a little bit about in this part of the show are liquidity and growth. And we'll get to growth here in just a minute. I want to start with liquidity. Talk about why that's so important. I feel like so often on this show, we really focus on income and protecting our income from taxes and all these other things. And we talk about growth. Why is liquidity such an important piece?
Well, believe it or not, life is going to happen.
All right.
And there's always going to be that liquidity event. Mm-hmm. Okay. Always going to be something that comes up that you didn't anticipate that you need money for. And if you have all your money in the market and the market happens to be down, or you have it tied up into, you know, it's part of your income plan, and you take money out of that, then you have less income for the rest of your life. So it's advisable to have liquidity where if you need it, you're not going to sell two shares for the price, sell two shares for the price of one.
Right.
And never get that money back. So we always suggest that you have liquidity, and typically 6 months of your anticipated budget is a good place to start. And I always like to think that if you had to go deeper, that you've got a resource. Let's say you have your house paid off, a line of equity that doesn't cost you anything, just available so that you don't have to do crisis planning. You can write a check to pay for that emergency and then figure out where's the best place to take that money from afterwards.
Okay.
So liquidity is extraordinarily important.
All right. So, and I think that's good to talk about because it does get overlooked sometimes. But as you're saying, life sometimes happens and we're still going to have things pop up where we need access to that money. It's just we don't want to have full access to 100% of our money. It's again, it's about a balance with all of these things.
Yeah, that's a good point, because too much in low interest rate accounts right now, safe, liquid, is going to come back to bite you.
Right.
Because inflation never sleeps.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. That too much of a good thing is a bad thing.
Right.
That's why I start with 6 months typically.
And I'm glad you mentioned inflation, because that's one of the reasons why we need to think about some growth potential in here as well. If we have everything too liquid, it's probably not going to be generating much in the way of growth. So talk a little bit about how we get that piece in here, because, you know, we probably don't get to go into retirement with just what we've saved and say, all right, that's it. We've got this amount and this is what I live on for the rest of my life. No other potential for growth, right?
Yeah, you know, the good old days, people could go to the bank and put their money there along with their secure pension and their secure Social Security, and they'd just be fine. And they didn't live quite as long. But now we've got to be concerned about longevity. Mm-hmm. We've got to be concerned with inflation. With interest rates being so low, we're going to experience inflation in our lifetime. So yes, we absolutely have to have some long-term growth. And you know, it's interesting. They call stocks securities, but I don't know how secure they are in the short term.
You're right.
Isn't that funny? They call them securities.
Yeah.
Over the long term, I'm going to say this. I believe that everybody should have the right amount in growth potential vehicles, such as stocks, mm-hmm. because but I say the right amount. Everybody's amount's going to be different, but everybody needs that. But the key is, over the long term, we know this. We look back in history and the market always does come back.
Right.
So even if we had, like, we go back to the lost decade, right? Mm-hmm. From 2000 to through 2009, really the S&P 500 was flat from the beginning to the end.
Right.
If you needed your money in the middle of that for income, you could have outlived your money.
Wow.
But if you just had that money to the side and you didn't touch it, at least at the end of that period of time, you were back and you let it grow a little bit longer and now you were good. So we need some long-term growth money, but we need to protect our money in the short term, make sure we have enough liquid, make sure we have enough solid income to keep up with inflation and to pay our income. But we also need a piece, or a pillar, if you will, as we're talking about them today, of long-term money that we don't need to touch until the long term. So that if we have a healthcare crisis later on in life, or inflation's crazy, or we lose some income because a spouse passes away, we've got it there. So we all need that, but we need the right amount of money in the long-term bucket, and we got to get the timing right. We got to get the timing right to match up with the risk. Very, very, very important to have growth potential. Otherwise, inflation's going to erode what we live on. And we're going to be in a hole. We're going to be in trouble if we just keep it under the mattress.
Right.
Or we put it all in the income.
Right. And I think, yeah, again, going back to doing this the right way, getting the right balance and putting this together in a way that makes sense, that's the key here. And Phillis, that's exactly what your Retire Fit analysis does. It helps us figure out which pieces we need as far as growth potential, protection, income, liquidity, all those main pillars of our retirement plans. That's really what your Retire Fit analysis is all about. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, that's exactly what it's about. What do we need the money to do when? What's the purpose of this money? We build purpose-driven plans, and the Retire Fit analysis walks us through the process of understanding what we need for money, what our money is doing now from all aspects, from a tax aspect, from an income aspect, from a growth aspect. And once we understand what it's doing, what are the gaps? And how can we build those pillars correctly so that we have the right amount of protection to protect from all the things that could come along and take away our lifestyle, our hard-earned money? What's the right amount of income? What do we need in the way of income to supplement Social Security? Right decision on that. Any pensions we may have, and inflation-adjusted income. How much do we need liquid for those emergencies? What are we comfortable with? Where are we going to get it from? And how much growth can we afford? What, you know, and we lay it all out so that you understand and can make well-informed decisions. You just can't have a medley, a bucket of money that's supposed to do income and growth and liquidity and healthcare, excess money needed. You just can't throw it all in like most people do during the accumulation phase, stocks and bonds, and not pay attention to tax diversification. So our Retire Fit analysis breaks it all down in those bite-sized pieces. So at the end of the day, you have that solid plan that gives you the right amount of protection, liquidity, growth potential, and income. And it all starts with picking up the phone and calling us at 623-792-5496. Again, 623-792-5496.
Phillis Sachs-Pilvinus is founder and president of PSP and Associates. That number again, 623-792-5496. Phillis, as we talk about the need for these things, the protection, the growth potential, the income, and the liquidity, do you think the main reason we need all of these things and is because of this idea that we're living longer in retirement? I mean, I think back to what retirement used to look like and how long people were retired. You've kind of alluded to this today, but we really need all of these things because we're talking potentially 3 or 4 decades in retirement, right? Can you just talk about the length of retirement real quickly here?
Oh, yeah. I mean, someone retires at 60 easily, at least if they're married, at least one of them can make it well into their 90s, yeah. If not both of them. That's 30 years without a paycheck. How do you do that without a plan that prepares for that? I don't see how.
Yeah, I really don't see how either. It just seems like something that we know fundamentally, and yet we kind of overlook it, or we don't fully think, or we don't fully understand just what things could look like 30 years into the future. It's kind of a disconnect.
And it's like, you know how we say kids today don't learn how to handle money the right way. They don't learn about the fundamentals of money. I say the same thing when it comes to retirement planning. I apologize if this is you, but whether you're close to retirement or whether you're already retired and you think you have a plan, if you don't have all these pillars, you probably don't have a plan. You're stuck in the accumulation phase, and that can come back to bite you. It is an entirely different. All the rules and tools that you use to get through the accumulation phase, they change when whatever you have is going to last you the rest of your life, and that could be a long time. Mm-hmm. So you need to build a fundamentally strong plan. And that's what we do with our Retire Fit analysis. First, we show you if you're on track to reach your goals with what you want out of your retirement. And if not, we show you how to put together a Retire Fit plan so that you get to and through retirement successfully on your own terms.
That number again to reach Phillis Sachs-Pilvinus is 623-792-5496. Again, that's 623-792-5496. The website is retirewithpsp.com. Stay with us. We'll be back.
When it comes to your health, it's clear. You consult your doctor. So why not consult a professional when it comes to money? Just like your doctor, the advice you get from a financial advisor can have a direct impact on your quality of life. Are you paying too much in fees with your current financial professional? What could happen to your nest egg if there's a market correction? If you're unsure, it may be time for a second opinion. Phyllis Sachs-Pilvinus is an independent advisor. She doesn't have a boss on Wall Street. Phyllis and her team at PSP and Associates specialize in designing retirement strategies that can allow you to spend more time enjoying life and less time being concerned about your finances. Get your second opinion. 623-792-5496. Phyllis Sachs-Pilvinus and PSP and Associates can help make sure your golden years are just that. Golden. 623-792-5496. That's 623-792-5496. Investment advisory services are offered through PSP Financial Services, LLC, an Arizona registered investment advisor. Phyllis Sachs-Pilvinus is also a licensed insurance agent in the state of Arizona.
Is your retirement plan ready for the long haul? Get a second opinion today from Phillis Axville Venus. Just call 623-792-5496. That's 623-792-5496.
Thanks for joining us today on Retire Financially Fit with Phillis. I am Jen Rizak, happy to be here alongside Phillis Sachs-Pilvinus. She is founder and president of PSP & Associates, author of the book Creating Calm Amidst the Storm, and she gets questions each and every week about all things retirement, and we want to devote some time in this last part of the show today answering some of those questions. But before we get into it, Phillis, there are some questions that you say we need to be able to answer as it relates to what's going on with our income. So let's review those real quickly. Let's go over those key questions, and then we'll get to our mailbag questions here in just a moment.
Okay, so if you can, first of all, really the key component of a retirement plan is the income plan. And if you can't answer these questions, then you truly don't have an income plan. And I want you to call me at 623-792-5496. These are the important pieces of what an income plan should look like. And it should be everything synthesized to very simple couple of papers that answer these questions. First, you have your budget. You know what you want, you know, your lifestyle to, what it's going to cost you to maintain your lifestyle. You've ironed all that out. And then your income plan should tell you very simply, you know, when is this income going to start? How much am I going to get out of the gates? Where am I going to take it from first? Mm-hmm. Second, what order am I going to take things from? When's Social Security going to kick on? How are we going to do that? Am I going to take it from all my different, you know, am I going to take it from my Roth? Am I going to take it from my IRA? Am I going to take it from my bank account? Real simple, okay? Already figured out what's going to be the most tax efficient, what's going to make the most sense from a risk position. How do I get raises? Where am I getting raises from? When? We know inflation erodes money. Where are those raises coming from? Real simple. Where are they coming from? Not how, but where. Mm-hmm. Okay. What happens if, you know, I'm married and my spouse passes away and I lose the Social Security, my taxes go up? Where is that extra money coming from? And if one of us, or if I'm just single and I have a catastrophic illness, where is that money coming from to pay for custodial care? It should be simply laid out, thought of, planning for the worst, hoping for the best. And the last question, this is the biggest thing that people always ask me. Phillis, how long is my money going to last? A real income plan is going to answer that question very simply. It's going to last this long. It's going to last that long. And you can see it laid out. If you can't answer these questions in a simple way, not going through tons of paper and saying, oh, I got it over here and I got it over here, but in a simple format, if things have not been synthesized down for you, that it's that easy, you don't have an income plan. If you call me at 623-792-5496, as part of our Retire Fit analysis, we're going to look at all your stuff to see if somewhere in there we can synthesize things down to answer these five questions in a way that will give you the retirement that you've always worked hard for. 623-792-5496.
RetireWithPSP.com is the website, and the number again, 623-792-5496. RetireWithPSP.com is how you can connect online and to send in your questions. And let's go ahead and get into our mailbag here now, Phillis. Appreciate you going over those questions that we need to be able to answer. But now I have some questions that you need to be able to answer from some of our listeners.
Let's see, the pressure's on.
Exactly. So our first question is Troy, who is from Goodyear, who's been looking forward to retirement for years. Now that he's less than 2 years away from his target retirement date, he is starting to panic. And he wants to know if this is normal. Do people get cold feet about retirement? Do other people have this? And how does he shake it off so he can actually enjoy his retirement? Boy, hey, isn't that the big question?
Hey, Troy, thanks for asking that question. And really, I understand the panic behind it if you don't have a plan.
Yeah.
All right? And it is normal, even if you do have a plan, that last minute, let's face it, you've been doing this forever. But really, the way to what people want when they retire is control over their money, confidence. Mm-hmm. Right. And it leads to comfort. And the way to have that happen is what I talk about each and every week. Let's make sure that we go through the pieces of the retirement puzzle and make sure that you have a plan for the worst that hopes for the best, that mm-hmm. solves all these things. And once you can see it laid out in front of you, you're going to have that comfort. But if you don't have a plan and you don't know, you know, where your income's coming from and whether you're tax efficient or not, whether you have a plan, if there's, you know, whether you have a tax bomb in your future that could blow things up, whether you have too much risk, all of those types of things, then I understand why you're nervous, but it can be avoided by just making sure, you know, I'd like to believe you're going to choose me since you asked the question, but a retirement planner, someone like me who's going to take you through all the pieces of the plan and show you where you are. Yeah. And if there's any issues, you can fix it that way. So I get it, but really there's no reason. I really believe strongly, Troy, if you have a plan in place that you can see and understand, that fear will go away and you'll have a great retirement.
Right. And let me just throw out really quickly a resource for somebody who is a few years out. Take the checklist challenge. You can find that at pspoffers.com/list. This is one of those places where you can start. You can go through and gauge just how ready you are. And that's where you can start to see where the gaps are. Then you might want to pick up the phone and give Phillis a call. But start with the checklist challenge. If you don't feel comfortable making that call just yet, start there. It's a free download, doesn't take a lot of time, but can be really eye-opening for you. pspoffers.com/list is where you can find it. Again, then Phillis is right here waiting if you want to ask some of those questions after you've identified the gaps. But start with the checklist challenge. It's a really great resource for you. One more time, that's pspoffers.com/list is where you can find that. Let's move on to our next question. This is Bryce, who is from Peoria, who has friends who are struggling right now because the husband was in a debilitating car wreck and they weren't financially ready to live on the wife's paycheck. And they don't know if he's going to recover enough to work again. So that's a really serious situation for these folks. Now, Bryce and his wife are wanting to make sure they're going to be okay if something happens to one of them. And they just want to know where they should start. And I mean, Phillis, you know how that goes. I mean, something can change in the blink of an eye and you're just scrambling to react. And we can do some planning for those things.
Oh, absolutely. So, Bryce, first of all, I'm so sorry for your friends. That's awful.
Yeah.
And I know we all get busy and things get away from us, but I'm really glad that out of this bad situation, it's got you and your wife thinking about, hey, how can we make sure that this doesn't happen to us?
Yeah.
And it all really starts with understanding what you need your money to do, what it's actually doing now, and if there are any gaps. It's our, you know, our retire fit analysis. It'll take you through all of that. And even if you're not close to retirement, you know, if you're within 10 years or so of retirement or even 15, it'll still do the same thing. It'll put your ducks in a row and show you if there are any ducks that we got to straighten out.
Stray ducks.
Yeah. Yeah. So get a plan. Make sure, figure out what you need to accomplish with your money, what's important to you guys, and what's actually happening with your money. Mm-hmm. And that's the way to avoid it. And it really comes down to being proactive versus reactive so that, you know, there are going to be storms. There just are. Mm-hmm. I mean, geez, the pandemic showed us that, right?
Yeah.
But if we have a plan, we're going to be calm throughout that storm. Does that sound familiar, Jen?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it all boils down to that. But yeah, great advice there for someone like Bryce who, and I think you're right. The silver lining is the recognition that there are some things that we need to be thinking about as well. So really appreciate taking the time to do that. Let's do one more question here. Phil from Glendale, who writes that his father-in-law keeps giving financial advice. He is very well-meaning, but it is driving Phil crazy. Would it make sense to get a second opinion so I can assure him that we have a solid financial plan? So again, father-in-law wants what's best for everybody, just wants to make sure we're good. So how do we double check and make sure, get that second opinion?
Yeah, Phil, that's great that you have your father-in-law in your corner, but I can understand how it can be annoying. I mean, yeah, I mean, what does he know about your situation? What doesn't he know? What's his skill level? Absolutely, getting a second opinion won't hurt. And you know what? It's probably going to give you more confidence.
Yeah.
It really will. It can't hurt anything. And, you know, advisors such as myself, we're going to do it complimentary. And if someone won't, that's kind of crazy.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
And make sure everything, it can't, I don't know what it can hurt for you other than give you either more confidence in that you're doing the right thing, or, geez, you've got some things that you really need to do differently, and here's why. It'll educate you on those things. And, you know, we're always happy to do that with people. And if they're in great stead, we tell them that. Mm-hmm. And if there are some issues that they need to address, we're going to tell you that too. And then we sit down and decide, and, you know, do we want to work together? Is it a good fit? Either way, I think it would be great for you at, you know, and put your father-in-law's concerns to rest by saying, yeah, now we have two opinions and we feel solid.
Yeah.
So that'd be great.
Well, and I think it's such a good point when you point out that sometimes you might find out that you are in really good shape. Sometimes people, they avoid that idea of a second opinion because they're afraid to find out that they've made a mistake or that it's going to be bad news. But gosh, a lot of times people have done a lot of things right. And it helps to get some reassurance there.
Absolutely. And, you know, geez, I don't have a problem with that. Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank goodness we have a great business. We love to help people. That's why we do what we do. And if someone comes through and they're in good stead, I don't have to try to make everybody a client. And,
sure.
And it's nice to tell them that. And oftentimes it's refreshing to those people and they refer their friends. So it all works out in the wash. So yeah. And there's no reason, not to be afraid. If there's a problem, you want to address it head on, proactive versus reactive, so you don't have an issue later on when it's too late to make those changes. So I commend your father-in-law for being such a good parent that he cares about you. And, you know, a second opinion will put this to bed for you and hopefully as well for your father-in-law.
You can get that second opinion from Phillis at 623-792-5496. That's 623-792-5496. And I'll throw out the other resource one more time as well, that checklist challenge. For those of you who maybe you just don't feel like you're quite at the point where you want to make the phone call, maybe you just want to start assessing your retirement readiness and see where you are, see if there are any gaps, and then you might want to make the phone call after that. Do the checklist challenge. We invite you to do that. It's free. PSPoffers.com/list is where you can find that. That's PSPoffers.com/list. Thanks for joining us today on Retire Financially Fit with Phillis. We'll be back next week with more insights from Phillis. We'll talk to you then. Have a great week.
If you've been laid off or you left your company, before you do anything with your 401k, find out all the ins and outs. Call Phillis today, 623-792-5496. That's 623-792-5496.
Investment advisory services are offered through PSP Financial Services, LLC, an Arizona registered investment advisor. PSP Financial Services is an independent financial services firm that helps people create retirement strategies using a variety of insurance and investment products. Investing involves risk, including the potential loss of principal. Any references to safety, security, or guaranteed lifetime income generally refer to fixed insurance products, never securities or investment products. Insurance and annuity product guarantees are backed by the financial strength and claims-paying ability of the issuing insurance company. PSP Financial Services, LLC is not permitted to offer, and no statement made during this show shall constitute tax or legal advice. You should talk to a qualified professional before making any decisions about your personal situation. We are not affiliated with the U.S. government or any governmental agency. This radio show is a paid placement.